Today, I shall discuss the importance of business research in decision making. That means, why research for business decision? To understand the reasons and to identify the reasons, we shall discuss the following topics. We shall discuss problem and research. That is the relationship between problem and research and definition of problem and definition of research. We shall also discuss decision. That is what is a decision and intuitive decision and rational decision. And then we shall try to connect six senses of human beings and the research. And at last, we shall discuss why research for business decision. The first thing is the relationship between problem and research. Now, if there is no problem, there is no question of research. That means when there is a problem, to solve that problem, research is conducted. That means the problems are defined, then data collected, data analyzed, and the main purpose is to solve the problem. So, we see there is a relationship between problem and research. So, problem is the basis for conducting research. Power, Mibaghan and Tumani said that no problem, no research. Problem is something that someone would like to research. However, problem must be researchable. Dear learners, now we shall see what is a problem. A problem is an obstacle which makes it difficult to achieve a desired goal, objective or purpose. Problem refers to a situation, condition or issue that is yet unresolved. In broad sense, a problem exists when an individual becomes aware of a significant difference between what actually is and what is desired or expected. Problem can be defined by asking six questions. That means, what is the nature of the problem? We can identify by asking six questions. That means, what is that problem? Where is this problem? How is this problem, and why is this problem, and who and when is this problem? Dear learners, now we shall see the details of these questions to understand the nature of the problem. First question is what? That means, what do I want to achieve? What are the facts? What would happen if no decision was made or solution found? And what do I need in order to find a solution? Why? Why do I need to achieve a solution? Why did the problem or opportunity arise? Why do I need to find a solution or way forward at all? How? How will the solution be different? How relevant is the information I am gathering? How can I find out more? And how can I involve relevant people? Where? Where did the issue arise? Where does it impact? Is the where important? If so, why? Who? Who am I trying to please? Who cares about this situation? Who is affected? Who is involved? Information, help, action. Who needs to be informed? And when? When did the issue arise? When do we need to act? And by when must it be resolved? Dear learners, now we shall discuss what is a research. Research means re-answers. That means search again. Systematic searching the facts, and based on that facts, making the decision for solving the problem. So research is a process by which problems are defined, the data collected, data analyzed, and then findings are identified, and based on that decisions are taken and which is used for solving the problem. More specifically, according to Redman and Murray, research is a careful and systematized effort of gaining new knowledge. According to Clifford Woody, research comprises of defining and redefining problems, formulating hypotheses or suggested solutions, collecting, organizing and evaluating data, making deductions and reaching conclusions, and at last carefully testing the conclusions to determine whether they fit the formulating hypothesis or not. We shall see what is a business research. Business research is conducted to solve the business problem. That means business research is a process of defining the business problem, collecting and evaluating the data, and then analyzing data, and then coming to the conclusions and results after the analysis of data, and solve the problem by the findings of the research. For example, a manager may find that his sales are declining, but he does not know why. So in this case, that manager can go for conducting research and identify the reasons for the declination of the sales. And based on the research findings, the manager can take the actions to increase the sales. More specifically, business research is the application of the scientific method in searching for the truth about business phenomena. These activities include defining business opportunities and problems, generating and evaluating ideas, monitoring performance, and understanding the business process. Business research must be objective. Research information is neither intuitive nor haphazardly gathered. It is detached and impersonal rather than biased, and it facilitates the managerial decision process for all aspects of a business. Dear learners, now we shall see what is a decision. A decision is nothing but selecting the best alternative from two or more alternatives. So to identify the alternatives, we need to conduct research. Now we shall see a specific definition of a decision. Decision is the choice made among two or more alternatives, as I mentioned. Decision making occurs as a reaction to a problem. And problem is a gap between present state and expected state of affairs. Decision can be divided into two types, such as intuitive decision and rational decision. Now we shall see specific explanation of intuitive decision and rational decision. Intuitive decision making is almost the opposite of rational decision making, being more instinctive, that is inherent, subjective and subconscious in nature. Managers who use this approach avoid statistical analysis and logical processes. These managers basically rely on their feelings and experiences about the situation and then make the decision. And rational decision-making processes consist of a sequence of steps designed to rationally develop a desired solution. It is a multiple-step process for making choices between alternatives. The process of rational decision-making favors logic, objectivity and analysis over subjectivity and insight. Now we shall see how our six senses are connected to research. Research can help us to sharpen our six senses. Now we shall see what are the six senses of human beings. The five senses and the sixth sense are sight, hearing, smell, taste, touch, and extrasensory perception. A sixth sense could be proprioception. That means the perception of body position, which is important for balance and agility, that is liveliness in movement. It could also include perception of stimuli from within the body, such as pain, hunger, or thirst. Saying goes that the seventh sense, that is love. Love can destroy all six senses of human being and makes him or her senseless. Please look at this board. You will see here so many things are written, and this person is thinking about those information and the indications. That means this is a research that can stimulate the thinking process of human being. Dear learners, now we shall see why research in business decisions. The reasons are gathering crucial information about consumers and business customers. Businesses use research to ascertain the success of their endeavor, like advertising. A business can make well-informed decisions due to research. Research is important for managerial decision-making. Research helps in testing the potential success of new products. Research helps to identify the potential consumers and customers and their habits. And of course, research can help keeping eyes on its competition. Research is important for all types of businesses, from small to large sized businesses. For a small business, if the business entrepreneur can identify the cost effectiveness, then entrepreneur can make the decision and then the business can run better. And for the large businesses, phases and the stages of large businesses, research is a must. Without conducting research, large business cannot make any decision. And if decisions are made based on intuitiveness or only experience of the managers, then there might have uncertainty and risk of making that decision as wrong decision. The first reason for research in business decision is gathering crucial information regarding consumers and the business customers. A business has to run with the help of customers. That means customers are the king. So if there is no customer, there is no business. So to collect the information, the income level, the purchasing power, and the purchasing habits of the customers and the consumers, manager or the organization has to collect information and analyze the information, and based on it, the organization or the business supplies the goods and services to those customers and the consumers. So collecting or gathering information is crucial for running the business. Second, businesses use research to ascertain the success of their endeavors, like an advertisement. For example, a dairy manufacturer may want to find out what percentage of the people saw its advertisement, latest TV commercial. The dairy manufacturer may find that more individuals become aware of its advertising the longer the TV ad runs. The company may decide to run its TV ads at different times if few people have seen the advertisements. A business can make well-informed decision due to research. In research process, the business will be able to acquire details about key business areas, analyze it, create a strategy, and distribute business information. Reports presented to the top management often contain details on consumer and employee preferences and all the available channels for sales, marketing, finance, and production. Management makes use of these details to determine the best strategy. Research is a necessity at all stages and phases of business operations. Initial research is also needed to evaluate whether getting into the given kind of business would be profitable and whether there exists demand for the proposed product or not. Fourth, research is important for managerial decision. Management has to make decisions for different reasons or for overcoming or solving the problems. Through research, all strategic business areas are analyzed and evaluated. Then techniques for more efficient procedures are created. All businesses usually have many ways of doing an activity. Through proper research, the organization will be able to pick the most effective, productive, and profitable one. Research could possibly be applied to marketing, production, finance, IT, and human resources. Fifth, research helps in testing the success of potential products and services. Businesses have to understand what kinds of products consumers would like before they market them. For instance, a restaurant may in the beginning interview focus groups to test types of burgers. The focus groups will probably include small teams of consumers. The goal of the focus group may be to figure out which burger customers prefer, and ultimately the company may test the burgers through surveys with larger groups of people. Sixth, research can help to identify the potential consumers and the customers and their buying habits. One of the most valuable kinds of research in business decisions is market research. This is information a business collects or purchases about its potential consumers and its buying and their buying habits, with the goal of better understanding their customers' needs. This information is then used to make decisions about new product offerings, pricing, and advertising to best meet the market's demand. It also provides information to indicate when a business strategy is underperforming or unlikely to be effective so that your business can cut costs where necessary. Seventh, research can help keeping eyes on its competition and competitors in the market. It is wise for a business to always keep a careful eye on its competition. Research into the activities and plans of competitors, called competitive intelligence, provides insight about their potential weakness and opportunities for your business growth. In addition, competitive intelligence can indicate weaknesses, including places where competitors are particularly effective in meeting consumers' needs. Armed with this information, managers can make strategic decisions about how to best position their business to secure a solid place in their market. Dear learners, we are at the last stage of this lecture on why research in business decision. We learned the relationship between the research and the research problem. We discussed what is a decision and the difference between intuitive decision and rational decision. We also discussed the six senses of human being and how these six senses are connected to research, and we identified and discussed the different reasons for research in business decision. Dear learners, I hope that this lecture will help you to understand the introduction to research and the necessity of business research for making the decisions by the managers. And this lecture will be useful for you to understand the managerial decisions through business research. Thank you.